So we wrote a paper called Hydrogels with Tunable Stress Relaxation Regulates Stem Cell Fate and Activity, published in 2015, and the researchers were interested in studying mesenchymal stem cells and how they spread, proliferate, and differentiate in vivo. So a bit of background, when studying cells, it's pretty common to either use 2D or 3D cell cultures. 2D cell cultures are what we commonly see where we're plating cells, but the problem with this method is that it doesn't really mimic in vivo conditions, and these researchers are really interested in seeing what these stem cells are doing in vivo. So they want to use 3D cell cultures which mimic natural extracellular matrices more closely, which is good because they're more elastic and flexible so that cells can interact with each other more naturally. So the overall goal of creating these cell cultures is so that they mimic natural extracellular matrices. Natural ECMs are viscoelastic and exhibit stress relaxation, which means that initially when cells apply forces to it, it'll experience resistance. That's defined by the material or the ECM's natural elastic modulus, but over time that resistance will decrease. So you can see in this provided figure that naturally reconstituted ECMs exhibit this viscoelasticity and stress relaxation over time. However, synthetic hydrogels that are used for 3D cell cultures do not. They're purely elastic and do not exhibit stress relaxation. So the problem with this is that natural cellular processes such as proliferation and migration are inhibited in these elastic hydrogels. So the goal of the researchers was to be able to control the stress relaxation and viscoelasticity of synthetic hydrogels to better observe the natural cell processes of stem cells.
So for the methods for alginate preparation, sodium alginates with high molecular weights were irradiated by a cobalt source to produce low and medium molecular weights, which were then determined by HNMRs to determine the structure of the alginates. For the mechanical characterization using a rheometer, periodically the storage modulus was recorded during the 45 minutes, and then initial elastic moduli and stress relaxation properties of alginate gels were measured from compression tests of the gel disc. Strain was held constant while the load was recorded as a function over time. For characterization of cell degradation, the hydrogels were incubated, frozen, and then lyophilized, and then the dry mass was then measured. For the cell culture, D1 cells were put in the mixture described on the slide, and then the medium was changed every 3 to 4 days. And for the encapsulation of cells and hydrogels, they were the cells were trypsinized, then mixed, put in the mixture with alginate and DMEM calcium sulfate, and then were put in a gel and then taken out after 45 minutes. Then for the immunohistochemistry, they were washed in CPBS for 3 times, and then using typical immunohistochemistry standard protocol, they were frozen and then stained. For the image analysis, YAP nuclear 3D localization was used to determine the nuclear area as well as the cytoskeleton area outside of the nucleus, and the DAPI channel was used for the nuclear area as well, and the phalogen channel was used to determine the cell body area. For the analysis of MSC differentiation, a variety of stains were used, and then they were quantified ALP enzyme activity as well, using an ALP bovine buffer solution. For the FRET measurements of RGD clustering, RGD acceptors and donors had an energy transfer, which was then measured, and then this transfer was because of the acceptor molecule giving energy to the donor one for the RGDs. And then the inhibition studies, it was a variety of inhibition protocols were used using inhibitors and on phosphatase activity.
So since the researchers were trying to simulate viscoelasticity in a hydrogel, they introduced low molecular weight alginates, making it up the structure so that there was decreased connectivity in the matrix, allowing for relaxation. In addition, some of the samples also had PEG spacers to further allow the polymers to slide past one another. So the researchers measured the stress relaxation as a function of the initial stress, so with that index to 1.0, and also measured the tau 1/2, which is the time it took to get to 50% of the original stress. They also found no statistically significant change in either the initial elastic modulus or the change in dry mass of the material, indicating that there was no degradation and no change in the fundamental mechanical properties besides stress relaxation. Next, they incubated fibroblast cells on the novel hydrogel and saw that when the hydrogel was relaxed faster, there was much more cell spreading. They ran an assay where they measured a bounding box around each cell and then took the length of the longest axis. And on Spearman's rank correlation with a p less than 0.0001, they found that the faster stress relaxation and an RGD tripeptide sequence that allows for cell adhesion were increasing cell spreading. After that, they wanted to see how this could be used to allow for mesenchymal stem cell differentiation. So on the top is an oil red O stain testing for differentiation into adipocytes. And we can see that at the 9 kilopascal elastic modulus and slower stress relaxation, the cells were preferentially differentiating into adipocytes. And on the bottom, an alkaline phosphatase assay showed that at the 17 kilopascal elastic modulus and faster stress relaxation, they were preferentially differentiating into osteocytes. And next, to test what the mechanism of action was, that cells were sensing the relaxation speed, they first ran an ALP immunofluorescent assay just to test for osteogenic differentiation, and then also immunofluoresced for beta-1 integrin proteins, and you can see the red outline around the cells showing that they were an external protein. They also ran FRET for those RGD tripeptides in the hydrogel that were allowing for cell attachment, and you can see the shadows around the cells showing that the cells were actually remodeling the hydrogels to put the RGD tripeptides around the cells. So that from this, we can see that the integrins and the RGDs are binding outside the cells, causing, during the polymer reorganization, during relaxation, cells are preferentially differentiating. They also tested for a few common geometric sensors that cells have, and these were not playing a role, showing that this was actually the mechanism of action.
So the overall objective of this experiment was to look at the two-way interaction between stem cells in their surrounding ECM. Specifically, the researchers wanted to look at how those interactions can affect cell spreading and proliferation. So it was found that in this experiment, the reforming of the ECM allows cells to spread, which eventually allows them to differentiate into different types of cells. And it was also found that the reforming of the ECM leads to degradation, and then that degradation allows for the growth of structural tissues such as bone or cartilage. And the researchers concluded that there were two main factors involved in MSC differentiation. So the first one was the stress relaxation rate. So they found that the faster the matrix stress relaxes, the more quickly cells can spread and eventually differentiate. The second major factor was the initial elastic modulus of the matrix. So here is a visual overview of the hypothesized mechanism for how viscoelasticity of the ECM can affect cell spreading and differentiation. So this first transition shows how the initial elastic modulus can affects the amount of force that's exerted on the cell by the ECM. So in the case of a purely elastic matrix, you can see that there is no deformation, and so the cell is not able to spread over time. But in a more viscoelastic matrix, you can see that the fibers will start to realign, which leads to plastic deformation. And over time, those realignments will cause the matrix to change shape, which will allow the cell to spread. And then that spreading is what causes stem cell differentiation. So overall, we thought that this is a very promising study for stem cell research. The researchers were able to find a mechanism for how stress relaxation can affect the differentiation of MSCs. So in the future, similar techniques could be used to create hydrogels with specific mechanical properties so that MSCs can differentiate into specific types of cells. Also, these techniques could be used to regulate cell proliferation and tissue regeneration in the future. And here's our source, and thanks for watching.